Alright guys, we have got some really interesting gaming news to talk about in today's video. There's quite a lot to get into, so I wasn't sure which game I needed to put first in the title to get you guys' attention. But today we're gonna talk about some extremely important Hogwarts Legacy news, the thing I've been waiting for since the official reveal, but we're also gonna talk about the Sons of the Forest release date, as well as its new trailer. Finally, we can talk about this one. Also, we have a huge Bioshock 4 leak, as well as its reveal coming soon maybe, and the new game from Ken Levine Studio, which Ken is the official creator of Bioshock, so you should be excited. Let's get into it. It has been just a week since I talked about Hogwarts Legacy making a huge comeback, and having a big reveal very soon, like at the Game Awards soon, and now we've got even more confirmation of that, as well as Warner Bros., the parent company of Harry Potter and Hogwarts Legacy, being scared to show off the game because of the apparent controversy the game is in, because of its creator J.K. Rowling, saying comments about transgender people, which is just a bunch of articles because there's absolutely no controversy to have here, and they simply want to create one, or are scared of a vocal Twitter minority that are screaming to cancel the game for whatever reason they want. So, this leak, which could 100% be considered as true, comes from a prominent voice online for updates on Avalanche Software's Hogwarts Legacy game, and this person has leaked many things in the past, which actually turned out real, and is the second insider in a week to talk about this game, so I think all hands are on deck for Hogwarts. According to a man, the insider, and a set, which in this case and a set is some kind of showcase, has been prepared in the last days of this video, and ready for release from Hogwarts Legacy, but the final say on going public is in the hands of publisher Warner Bros. Interactive, and like I said before, they're a bit scared to show it off, even though I'm sure they will show it off anyway, because come on, it's one of the most anticipated games. It's so random to think that they're scared of the backlash because there isn't gonna be anything at all in my opinion, if you don't follow those who like to spit on things, that doesn't follow what they want. So please just don't follow any website journalists for this one. I'd say DSOGaming.com and Podcast Now on YouTube are the only ones you should follow if you want to know more about anything gaming without the bullshit, and also myself if you'd like. So, an Hogwarts Legacy asset, meaning definitely a showcase, is ready to be shown, and it all coincides with the other leak that an insider talked about, which said Hogwarts Legacy will have a new reveal this December 9 at the Game Awards. All hands are on deck for this day, and I will definitely be covering it. Next up, we have the official release date of Sons of the Forest, as well as its new trailer, which pretty much shows everything we need to know before getting it. Before that, updates on this game were really scarce, and no one really seemed to know what the game was all about. The developers are known to keep everything a secret until they're ready to show something big, and it happened yesterday, where they shared the official release date trailer. And Night Games developers moved Son of the Forest launch date from 2021 to May 20, 2022, giving the game another 6 months of polish and tuning before going live, which is not that far, especially with all these delays recently, and it's nice to have a new trailer that comes with it. The new footage showed a lot of new things, including unique monsters never seen before in the first game, a new updated building system, some action with the guns and melee weapons, and also goes beyond the first game with the survival tools at our disposal. You can create brand new tools and items, make bigger and better settlements, and much more. The trailer ends showing a part of the game's story, which is a direct continuation of the original game. I cannot wait to play the game this May, and I hope they won't delay it again. Next up, we have what might be our very first Bioshock 4 news. Well, not Bioshock 4, but Bioshock Isolation news, because according to a leak, the new game is called just that, and we also have its first details, if it is indeed true. The first details of Bioshock Isolation seems to have leaked just now before 2K Games and Bioshock's developer Cloud Chamber were to reveal the game at the Game Awards on December 9. Along with this, this rumored insider said this game will be running all on the Unreal Engine 5 and is being developed by returning Bioshock developers and also people who have worked on Watch Dogs Legion, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Mafia 3, Deus Ex, and more. This leak also claims that the game will take place in two different cities that are opposed to one another and are completely different than each other. One of these cities lies underground and is led by a dictator who is waging war on the second city that sits above, which again are both completely different cities. The latter city is said to be much more wealthy and is led by an entrepreneur who we think is the good guy. When it comes to a release release date on this project, no window was given at this point in time, but it is not sure if the game will either be revealed in early 2022 or at the Game Awards, because the insider talked about an announcement in early 2022, but later retweeted Jeff Keighley's tweet about a big world premiere making its debut after 2.5 years of being worked on, which coincidentally coincides with the new Bioshock being announced exactly 2.5 years ago, and this reveal is set to be at the Game Awards. This Game Awards really feel like it's gonna be something special, and I cannot wait to see this happen. If the new Bioshock is revealed there, then we're in for a really good time. If you didn't know already, there was a major leak from the Nvidia GeForce Now database in September 2021, and it included a listing for Bioshock 2022, which could be related to Bioshock Isolation, definitely, meaning a Bioshock release in 2022 might not be so far off. Addressing the leak, Nvidia told everyone that while the leak was real, the inclusion of any game on it doesn't mean anything, which could be true or false, and they're trying to hide the mistake. Coinciding with this is Ken Levine's next game that might also be revealed at the Game Awards. Ken, which is the creator of Bioshock, and is working on a title inspired by Bioshock itself, but going even more into the insanity, but staying in action RPG project, that introduces an upgraded Nemesis system from Shadow of Mordor, where people remember you and what you've done throughout the whole game, which what you do and say can change the whole story. I've been waiting for such a long time on this one, and I'm hoping we get to see it there. Ghost Story Games, which was founded by Levine in 2017 after leaving the now shuttered Bioshock Infinite developer Irrational, is dedicated to making immersive story-driven games for gamers that like a real challenge, he said. I can't really talk about the new game, but there's some weird shit in it, Ken Levine said. He goes on to say, I think if you don't have people saying, that sounds a little insane, you haven't gone close enough to the edge. Because the great stuff that exists on the edge of over the top and just okay, and sometimes you've got to push past the point and make something outrageous and ridiculous, then put it back. He added, but if you don't go to the outrageous and ridiculous, you never know where that boundary is. That means you've got to go into the office sometimes, tell people things, and they're going to look at you like you're insane, and then you sort of bring it back to something that you can actually accomplish. Other than that, the only big hints the studio gave regarding this new game is that it is a new immersive sci-fi game with RPG elements. The Game Awards is sure to be filled with some pretty good game announcements, and maybe even more for us, since they also tend to reveal more indie games. So I'm definitely up for whatever they're planning on that day. There's gonna be much to cover. Though we're not sure at all for Bioshock, and only time will tell, but let me know if you guys want me to cover more of Bioshock. Alright guys, make sure you subscribe to stay tuned, and of course support this video for more.